So I'm in our Hyundai Ioniq 38 kilowatt hour, and in this video I'm just going to show you how you update the software in the head unit here. So on the channel already I've got a video on how you do the same in a 28 kilowatt hour Ioniq, and I'll link that at the top of the screen, because on those it's a bit different. You use the SD card, which is in a slot somewhere here. On these you use the USB socket down there, and you've got to download the software and put it on a USB stick. So let's go and do that first. So the first thing you need to do is install the Hyundai downloader software on your computer. So if you go to update.hyundai.com, you'll go to this website. You can change your region up here. So I'm in the UK, so we're in the Europe/EU region, and here is the downloader software. And this is a program that you can install on your PC, and in this case Windows, or you can use the Mac version if you've got an Apple Mac, and that then installs a little downloader onto your computer, which I have got already here, which I've got running. And what you need then is a USB stick. You need a USB stick with a connector. So I'm just going to put that into the computer. Mine is a little bit awkward. It's a very tiny little USB stick. I never know which way around it goes, and it never quite fits properly. There we go. And mine is a 32 gigabyte, and you need at least a 32. So you want 32 or 64 gigabyte stick. You don't have to worry about formatting it or anything, because the software will do it. So next you've got to select your vehicle. In my case, I'm going to do Hyundai Ioniq Electric, and you can then select what year you've got. That's the 28 kilowatt hour version. This is the 38 kilowatt hour. So I'm going to select that and then select OK. And now it's just a case of selecting your drive. There it is, drive D, 28.9 gigabytes. And it says there it needs a 25 gigabytes of space and 53 gigabytes of hard disk space. It's going to format it. If you want to change your drive letter, you can select that there, but mine's already selected the D. So it's just a case now of letting it do its thing. But I find this is slow. I don't know whether it's just my internet or my PC, but this section can take a good hour to download in my case. So this is all finished now. That's what it looks like. It has downloaded the information and it's put it onto the USB drive. So I can say OK on there. And in my case, that's taken probably nearly 3 hours, actually. It's taken a very long time, but I think that's more to do with my internet connection and the fact that this computer, well, the office here is on a bridge on the network, so the internet is rather slow. But anyway, that's done. I can take the USB stick now out to the car. But before I do that, you've got a link here where you can download the instructions to see what we've got to do next. So now we're back in the car and you need to start the vehicle, and you need to properly start it. So that is with your foot on the foot brake, and then start it. So it needs to be in ready mode. So now I'm just going to get rid of the blue link messages that we've got on here, because blue link isn't configured. And let's just take the sat nav off the screen there. So next, we take our USB stick and plug it in down there, and then it should automatically recognize that there is the operating system update files on the stick. So initially it's saying no media fan, because it was looking for music, and there we go. It's saying, do you want to do a system update? So let's do an update now. And I guess we want to do finalize update. And now that's going to start the process. So during this time, you've got to leave the vehicle running. Do not switch it off, otherwise you will corrupt the data. So you can leave the vehicle and leave it running, But leave your key in the vehicle. And if it's a nice day, it's good practice to drop your window. So if the car accidentally locks on you, at least your window's open and you can put your hand inside and open the door. Because I have had one of these. Well, it wasn't an Ioniq, it was a Kia Soul EV, but it's basically the same car. I once did lock the keys in it while it was running. And I couldn't get in any of the doors or couldn't get in the boot. And it was caused a bit of a tricky situation. So anyway, good practice to always leave the window open on modern cars when you've got wireless keys like you have nowadays. So that's now starting to update, and this stage takes a good hour or so. It's been a long time since I've done one of these, but I think it takes about an hour. But in this case, because I'm going to try to record it, I'm going to have to sit in the car. Hence why I've got a cup of coffee down there on the floor to drink while I'm waiting. So I'll try to capture all the key moments as it goes through this update. And also, you don't need to worry about the battery state of charge when you're leaving one of these running. It really will use minimal energy. In this case, I've got the heating going and the heated seat. And over an hour or two, it probably won't even drop a bar. But if you didn't have the heater going, you could run one of these for literally days and you'll hardly notice a drop in the state of charge. So you may notice when I first plugged in that USB stick and this update started that there was an option to run it when the vehicle was turned off, which I haven't seen that before. And I've updated these Ioniqs many times now, and I've never seen that option to update it when the car is off. Usually I've had to do what I'm doing now, either sit in it or leave it running and let it do its thing. So if you're doing this for the first time, you may not see that option to let it run when the vehicle's next turned off, and you might have to do it the way I'm doing it now. I'm assuming I've got that option because this vehicle's already got later software. This car has been updated at least twice already, so it's running newer software than probably you will be running in your vehicle. But anyway, we're now at 56% and it's been running for about 10 minutes so far. So this has taken 20 minutes to get to this stage. It got to 98% and then it's flicked over to this screen. So you just have to wait and let it do its thing. So now it's doing more updating. So as I said, I think this process takes about an hour in total. 90% of the viewers of this channel are not subscribed. I'm sorry to ask, but it would help greatly if you would. Just press the subscribe button. It's free and it shows YouTube you like this sort of vehicle related content. If you want to be notified when new videos are released, please click on the bell button also. Thank you, it really helps more than you would imagine. This went up to 97% and then went onto this screen. But that was much quicker, that's only taken 10 minutes. So that's now doing a complete reboot. Morton has collaborated. The radio's come on. And we're now back to the main screen. I can confirm on that and do a later on that because we're not running the blue link. So is this going to do another update? I thought it did a second one, but maybe that was on previous updates. No, doesn't look like that's going to do another update. So that's finished. So actually it was much quicker. I'm sure when I've done this in the past, it's ended up taking an hour. So in this case, it's taken about half an hour. So now we've got this what's new screen. So let's have a look to see what's new. Oh, and it's just saying it's been updated, so it's not going to tell us the detail of what's changed. So you're only going to find that out if you go through all the different apps. The one I am interested to see is radio, to see whether that is any different. No, it's not. It's still got this horrible interface. Oh well. So I won't go through all the changes in this software, because obviously it's going to depend on when you do it and what software version you're upgrading to. But anyway, I'll leave it there for now. That was a full update in only about half an hour, maybe 40 minutes at most. So if you found this video useful or interesting, as always, please do click the thumbs up. That really does help. Do subscribe to the channel. If you want to see other videos on the Hyundai Ioniq, I'll put a link below to a playlist where you can see other videos I've made. Okie doke. I'll see you on the next one. Oh yeah, and finally, obviously, you can now remove your USB stick and then turn the vehicle off.